She sought political asylum in the U.S., specifically here in Baltimore, and everything appeared to be by the book.
So why, after 20 years, is a Baltimore woman now staring down the possibility of deportation? I-Team investigative reporter Deborah Wiener explains.
Oh, let me have a hug.
These could be this Baltimore woman's last days in the U.S., which is why 48-year-old Perrette Tuisk holds on to the company of good friends as she faces possible deportation.
Baltimore is my home. I don't have any other homes anymore.
It was 20 years ago when Perrette and her family fled Estonia, which was then part of the Soviet Union. After arriving in 1991 with only $200, the Tuisks filed for political asylum in the U.S. In Estonia, we live in fear, they wrote on their asylum application. They said political demonstrations against the Soviets had them investigated by the KGB.
It wasn't a great place, really, to live. I was looking for a better future.
The family found that here in Baltimore. The Tuisk daughter went to public school and ultimately graduated from college at Stevenson University. Perrette bought a home, paid taxes, and went on to become a licensed massage therapist, every year applying for and receiving a work permit from the INS, or Immigration and Naturalization Services, all the while waiting for word from immigration about that application for political asylum.
As time went on, a lot changed for this family. The marriage ended and Perrette's husband remarried an American citizen, leaving Perrette to wonder what her immigration status really was. Well, she found out 17 years after filing for political asylum and building her life here, and the news wasn't good for her.
Remember, the family first filed for asylum in 1991. But it wasn't until January of 2008, 17 years later, that they were first interviewed in person by USCIS, or U.S. Citizenship and Immigration Services, which is part of the Department of Homeland Security. And then later that month, they received this notice. USCIS has not granted your claim for asylum. Even though the Tuists had been persecuted in the past in Estonia, because the country had changed, the letter said, there is not a reasonable possibility you would suffer persecution if you were to return. In other words, because Estonia is no longer under communist control, it is safe to go back 17 years later.
No, I don't want any.
Perrette's friends are stunned.
This is a land of liberty and justice, and this seems so unjust to me. What's happening to her?
This is a lady who is caught between a rock and a hard place.
This case has received the attention of well-known immigration attorney Cynthia Grooms Katz of Washington, who says she has never seen an asylum case languish this long.
The world has changed as her paperwork has basically been lost, or at least ignored.
It would appear so.
Grooms Katz points out that Perrette has no criminal record, is active in her church, and has become more of an American than an Estonian.
Is this the kind of person who should be kicked out of this country?
I don't think she is. I think she's an asset to this country.
The I-Team pressed USCIS for answers about this case and got very little. The only thing officials would tell us is that last year, all political asylum cases were resolved very quickly, in just 6 months' time. Ruth Wedgwood is a professor of international law at the Johns Hopkins School of Advanced International Studies.
I guess I'm not surprised that something could fall through the cracks for 17 years. I am surprised, though, I have to say, as a lawyer, that the INS would have the audacity to give a negative decision after 17 years.
The INS considers Perrette deportable because she remained in the U.S. for a time longer than permitted. The catch-22 here is that she was waiting for them to act.
If she had gotten asylum, say, 10 years ago, 12 years ago, she would then have been here permanently. You're not required to go back if you're an asylee just because the government's changed. It's an entitlement to remain.
Do you think that you're paying the price for people who have come here illegally?
I'm paying price for that.
On the original asylum application, the Tuisk family was asked if they would ever return to their home country. Back in 1991, they said yes, if the Soviets were gone and they had no other choice. Perrette not realizing back then that 20 years later, going back might not be her choice at all. For the 11 News I-Team, I'm Deborah Wiener.
Perrette is scheduled to appear before an immigration judge this summer, and so is now her 23-year-old daughter. The daughter's residency is also unclear, her future in Baltimore uncertain. The I-Team will continue to follow this case.